to another video. It's just gone 5:39. I'm at the top of Lee Mount, and there we have the sunrise. I hope that the sound's coming out okay. I'm having to use my old phone, and I can't use my windshield and mic on it because the jack is blocked from where my other one broke. And obviously, I'm using my other phone for the time lapse. I did set up both phones. The phone I'm using now to film on didn't, the time lapse didn't come out brilliant. The colouring is horrible, so using this one to film quickly and take some pictures of that stunning sunrise. I couldn't really be bothered to get up, but I've been on earlies all week. It started at like 3:53 in the morning, so my body clock's just about right for this really, and what a beautiful morning it is. It's a shame that there's no cloud cover. Obviously you don't want too much cloud, but a little bit of cloud would have been good. So I thought I'd just do a little video. I've not really done much uploading. I'm back to work now, so between family time and work, I've not really got much time. But I'm going to come out, obviously do this time lapse, and I'm going to crack on down the allotment in a bit and give you a little update of what's happening. I really need to get a t-shirt or a banner or something saying I'm not a train spotter. I was doing the time lapse of the sunrise and some old boy comes along, towel in his arm. I says, "Oh, is it a special one, is it?" So, excuse me. "Is it a special train?" I said, "No, mate, I'm not train spotting. I'm getting a sunrise." Nothing against train spotters, by the way. And then literally 2-3 minutes later, another old boy comes along, towel in his arm. He said, "Exactly the same thing, near enough." I said, "No, sunrise." And I said, "You going swimming, are you?" He's like, "Yeah." I said, "Some other chap's just gone down with a towel." So, yeah, they're nuts. The whales swimming in the sea. To be fair, actually, it's very, very warm. I wish I wore shorts as well as this t-shirt. And yeah, I thought I'd just do a little bit more filming here. As you can see, about here, you have a cruise ship, which is anchored just off Torquay. A couple of joggers just come up and they said, apparently there's a pod of dolphins lurking about just down here somewhere. I've not seen them yet. Even if I did, the camera probably wouldn't pick it up anyway. Such a nice morning. So, yeah, so what's coming up on the channel then? Well, weekend of the 7th of August, I should be going out wild camping. Originally, I wanted to do a solo wild camp on Dartmoor, and that would have been my last video as the Dartmoor Explorer. But I just fancy meeting up, I fancy a social. Originally, I planned, well, I asked wild camper and camp life and bushcraft if they could make it. Unfortunately, they can't. So I'm going out with some other chaps. And if you're watching this, honestly, you're not second best. It's just been wanting to meet Dan from camp life and bushcraft just a little bit longer. But yeah, these guys I've only met once, and they're amateur photographers, so they'll be teaching me a few things, even though I've just got the camera that I'm using now. I've still got a few tags I need to do. Andy Kent Survival and Dan from Camp Life and Bushcraft. They both tagged me for the three ingredients cooking tag. So I do apologise I've not got round to it. We couldn't have fires. We can have fires now. I just need to find a suitable place. and I've been tagged by Relo Brand. I'm sorry, I've not got round to it, but this is a really hard tag you've tagged me in. My favourite album, that's a very hard one, but I do promise I will get round to that very soon. And Dean from Life on the Rocks, I'll get round to your tag, mate. He's tagged me in, why do I enjoy backpacking? So there are a few extra videos I will be doing. In lockdown, I did say I wanted to do a load of videos on tying knots and different shelter configurations with the tarp. Now that's all stuff that should be easy enough to do at home, so I don't have to go out, I don't have to find the time to travel. But unfortunately my household is a very noisy household, so it's quite difficult for me to do any filming there. But there are going to be upcoming videos. I will try and work something out, try and find some time to go out and do them videos. The channel's going well, and I do thank you all for that, all my old subscribers and new subscribers. I'm just rambling on now. Also, just down here, you've got Horse Cove and Shell Cove. It's not going to be for a while, but I really, really want to get myself a kayak. I'm not sure if I mentioned that on here yet or not. You know, I could spend a few hundred pounds and get a inflatable one, but that's no good. You've seen the rocks. You know, it's not going to be any good going out there and getting a puncture. So I'm trying to save up and get a hard shell kayak. That again, that'd be some different videos to what I normally do. Right, before I bore you to death, let's crack onto the allotment. I won't do a lot of filming down there. Just show you what I have been doing, what I plan on doing, and I will leave the video there. So with a click of a finger, let's get down there. And there you go, we're here like magic. It's now 8 o'clock, as you can tell, I'm down the allotment. Let's show you what's what. Well, so you would have seen me dig this over in previous videos. But as you can see, the weeds, the bindweed, the thorns, and everything's all starting to come up through. But at least it's all turned over. The rhubarb I inherited. This is all the rhubarb that I took from the garden and the old allotment. This is what I've recently dug over. As you can see, it's mainly mud. The weeds are only just starting to come through. Because I can't really plant much this year, because it's about getting everything all sorted so it's workable, I'm keeping this random blackberry bush there so I can get something. So today I'm just going to dig a bit more over here. You see it's starting to look like a jungle again. I've chucked all the rubbish down here just for a minute. Some kind of berry bush there, don't know what it is. If anyone knows, let me know. Well, loads of blackberries down here. And a tiny little rhubarb plant down there that I've inherited too. I do need to come in, I've been told to come in and cut this back. Unfortunately, I forgot my shears, so I will do that next time. And I've got a humongous rhubarb plant here that I've inherited. My hand compared to the leaf. Not sure what this tree is, whether it's a fruit tree or not. We have a little wasp on there. So the plan is, when this is all dug over and done properly, I'll just stick you on the wide angle a minute. That's better, you should be able to see more now. So just for now, I've got my rhubarb up here, like I've shown you. That's only temporary. Eventually, I'm going to want all my rhubarb down in that section there, followed by maybe strawberries, and then all my veg will go up here. Now I want to build something to go up here. You're not allowed anything permanent, and you're not allowed sheds. I know on the outside you've got sheds, you're allowed sheds on the outskirts, but in the middle plots you're not allowed anything over 4 foot. So I could just dig a foot down, have like a 5 foot shelter, something just to get away from the weather and to store my tools in. Because at the moment, I hope I'm not making you feel sick by walking around with the camera. At the moment, I'm just storing my tools in the little composter there. But another option for the strawberries is to have them running down the side here and down the side here, because this plot is on a slope, so I could build like a strawberry bed and layer it all off coming down. But for this year, the main thing I need to do is dig all that back over, take the weeds out of here, buy some heavy duty tarpaulin and cover it. Hopefully that should do the trick. Look at that for a view. I know I've shown you loads of times, but I'm just so lucky to have a plot like this. And then that direction, Haytor, Dartmoor. Right, let's crack on. Right, I'm calling it a day now. That's me all done. It's only 20 past nine, but I knew I wasn't going to have long down here. So I've dug over this little bit here, as you can see. But it's so hot, I just gave up with that. So I just checked the temperature, it's 21 degrees. Like I said, only 20 past nine. But I gave up with digging it over, and I've just come over to de-weed this little patch here. So I've not done much, but I'm slowly getting there. I've not filmed myself doing it because I've had my t-shirt off, and you don't want to see my moobs. I've been sweating that much, it actually looks like I wet myself. The sweat's just pouring down at me and all over my crutch. Good job there's no one down here at the moment. So, if you watched this far, thank you very much. Bit of a random video, got a bit of everything. Got a sunrise, got a little bit of a channel update, and a bit of the allotment. So my next video should hopefully be my wild camp. So, yeah, I will see you on that one. Thank you very much, and everyone take care. Cheers.